Okay, here we are looking at my iPhone screen. You can see I've got the HB icon here on my screen and I'm ready to open the app. So I go ahead and click it, open the app. And now I'm in here. The first thing that I would do if I just opened it after a little while is I would put my thumb on the screen and pull down, see if there's been any new content. It's only been a few minutes since I opened it, so nothing new. But if you put your thumb on the screen and pull down, it'll say loading up here on the top, and if there's new content, it'll feed in the new content. All the content that you see here in the scroll is really based on an algorithm based on people and topics that you've chosen to follow. And generally, when you arrive here, you're just going to see all of the content that's coming in. And if you're not seeing a lot of content, you want to follow people. You want to follow, let's say, for instance, whoever put this up, Venetria, or Crow, Nye, or Sponsor Post, or Rojo, you follow them, or you follow the topic, topics where it says photos, you can click on that, and that'll give you the ability to follow it if you're not following it, and you want to try to follow as many things as you can so you can see as much new content as possible. You know, generally as you're scrolling through, if you see something that you like, say, wow, I think this color's nice, give it a heart. And you can see that those are right below the picture. If you wanted to make a comment, then you'd click on the comment and it would open up a screen and you can say whatever it is, just as you normally would, love this, post, and now you've got a comment. Then you can hit the back arrow button in the top left-hand corner and you're right back into the scroll. Very easy. If you see something and you want to get a closer look at it, all you have to do is tap the screen and it'll give you what they call kind of like a shadow box or window box display, so you can see it displayed a little bit more without any of the writing or anything on it. And then if you're finished looking at it, you just drag your thumb across it and push it away. And then you're right back into your scroll. Now, little things, what's great about the HB app is it recommends people for you to follow. So if you've chosen your profession as an educator and there are other educators out there that have done the same, every once in a while it'll recommend that you follow them and you can click on any one of these people to learn more about them and to follow. So this is a great way to build your connectivity with other people. You know, it'll keep recommending people that it thinks you should follow. And again, just like all social media, the more people you follow, the more topics you follow, the more content you're going to get. And that's the basics of the scroll. Now, if you want to go in a little bit more in depth, you can hit the little eyeglass on the bottom, the second icon on the bottom right here. And this is now going to take me into what we call search. Now, this is definitely super, super important to use. You'll see at the top, there's a search box. If there's a certain word, for instance, that you're interested in, like you heard there was a great article about score and barbers, you can put in a keyword and then search that keyword, and all the things that have something related to Scorum in it will come up, or whatever that topic might be. Let's say maybe extensions. It'll probably help to spell it properly. Try that one more time. There we go. So people and things related to extensions, if that was something that you're interested in or whatever the topic might be. Different people that have that word in their profile or content, anything like that. And we can go back. I hit the eyeglass, looking glass again. And then below the search bar, you can see brand new feature that we're launching is groups. And right now we've got the Hair Color Magic group in beta, and then we've got a private group for HB hosts, and you'll see this rolling out more. And if you wanted to join a group or you wanted to have a closer look, you could click on that group and see what's happening. So again, we're getting this Hair Color Magic group ready for all the Lupe Voss Hair Color Magic fans. You're going to have a great group coming up really soon. Top members, these are people that are contributing really frequently. And again, you can follow and see all other members near you. This is a great feature. I don't have my locale in, so there's no members near me. But if you had New Jersey or something like that, you could find different members, top members, new members, and members near you. Then as you continue to scroll down, you'll see that there's top posts. So these are things that are getting a lot of engagement at the moment that you might be interested in. Polls are very popular. So you can see there's a lot of polls because people engage with them. They're very easy to get involved with. And then you've got featured posts. Right now I'm featuring lots of posts on how to make sure people are getting up to speed on how to use the app best. You go down again, you can see the groups that are the busiest. That's a top group. Again, we've only really got one, so it's a top group right now, but we'll be rolling out more groups. Now, this is the most interesting part, I think. This is the topic area. So remember, whenever you put up content on Hairbrained, you need to tag that content. We've got pop-up screens now to remind you to tag your content, which is great. But let's say, for instance, you tag your content photo. Then it will go in this feed. And anyone interested in photos will come to the search page and they'll hit photo. And now they'll have a magical feed of everything that's tagged photo. So anyone that's interested in photos or is posting, this should really be all about photos. Well, if I want to go back, I can hit the search glass again and I can look at something else. Let's say I'm really interested in polls. I want to just really focus on polls. You can see that if it's been tagged poll, you'll be able to spend some time with polls. Hit the search glass again, hair color, styling, product brands. So all that's there. And we're actually even building on this in an update to come out soon. We'll be able to even feature the best of each one of these topics and make it even that much more fluid. Okay, so back to the bottom of the screen. The next thing you'll see next to the looking glass is the little messaging bubbles. And this is fairly simple. We all know how to message each other. And there's lots of messaging going on Hairbrained. It's a great way to connect with other hairdressers and really kind of build those relationships. Obviously, if someone says you welcome them to the group, hi, excited to use this app, I could say, obviously, very, very simple, click on it. And write a message back. Great to have you here. Again, looks like I spelled it right for once. Post, done. Back arrow in the left-hand corner. And then again, I could look at other messages that I've got. The next button basically is activity that's you've done or people that you followed, things that they've posted. So you can see there all these different people that I follow. I can see all their activity. It's loading. So either things that I've done or that people have done who I follow, messages that I've received, all the activities here, you know, and then after you've looked through, you can hit the mark all as red and that'll clear out the cache, so to speak. Then the last thing on the bottom of the screen there is your posting button. So when you want to make a post, you click on that and obviously you can either have something written here or you can go into your photos, go into your photo library, and pick a photo. Now, the way that the app is designed, square photos and very landscape photos don't display as well as full screen real photos. So you can see that this is a full screen photo of our friend Rob on stage at the teach-in, and that displays really well. If I didn't like that, I could go back and try to choose something else. And I'll show you something maybe that's square that wouldn't display as well. Let's see if I have any squares in here. So that's a square. It's displaying fairly well. And there's some great tips that I can show you in further videos on how to work with your photos to make them look the best. But let's just put up this one here of our friend Rob from Scorum. Now, if I want to write something on it, I just tap the screen, and there goes the keyboard. And here we go, the Bloody Butcher. That is his handle. Working it out. At teach-in. All right, I want to correct that because I want an uppercase, just like you would normally do. All right, now let's just say you forget to tag it, which people tend to do. But if you remember, you can hit the little tag icon right above the screen, the keyboard. There's a little tag icon next to the camera. But let's say you forgot to do it and you just hit post. So as a host, I'm allowed to notify everyone. You guys wouldn't have to see this, so I wouldn't worry about it. But I'm going to hit don't notify because I don't want to be super annoying every time I post something. But now it also asks you, would you like to tag this post? The answer is yes, because that's how people are going to find it and enjoy it as the scroll continues a week from now if people are looking for your contribution. So you want to hit add tag. And let's just say that this was education because it came from teaching. So I've tagged it, all these different tags that exist here. And, you know, we're always listening. If anybody, it feels like we're missing certain tags, let us know. Then you scroll back up and you hit done. You can make sure you like what you've got. And then you hit post in the top right-hand corner. Again, this is only for hosts. I'm not going to notify everyone. And that should post. Let's go back. Now I'm back to the feed. Whenever you want to go back to the feed, you just hit the little HB in the left-hand corner. And there's my post in the feed. So I've covered all the buttons on the bottom here. We'll go into more detail in future videos. Enjoy the HB app.